Belgrade. And they now are receiving their instructions from the American referee, Rudy Ortega. So we are now going to be underway here with Parlov, of course, the overwhelming favorite of the fans here. They just absolutely idolize him. It has been quite a sight and quite an experience to see in the past couple of days since he arrived in town from his home up in Pula, to see how literally everybody on the streets and buses, street corners, recognized him. Anybody who saw him knew who he was. We're underway in round one. On your left, John Conteh in white. Conteh Parlov in blue, now circling to your left. Conteh Parlov, 21 wins, one loss, one draw. The loss and the draw to Matt Franklin of the U.S. John Conteh, 31 wins, one loss, no draws, 22 knockouts along the way.
John Conteh's trying to set a pattern. You've got to fight pressure with a left-handed fighter, a southpaw to put it exactly. But he's going to find a very awkward guy in Parlov. He's not that easy to get to, and very difficult guy to figure out because he has sort of a stutter type of movement. He's a real good fighter and a good champion.
Well, what Conteh has to do is move to his left, keep his left foot outside of Parlov's right foot. And I think he's doing a pretty good job so far. Let's see if he keeps it up. It really takes concentration, fighting a southpaw.
Conteh has been sparring against a tall southpaw from London, Tommy Kyle, during his training here in Belgrade. Conteh weighed in at 173, easily under the 175 limit. Some speculation that Parlov had a little trouble making the weight, but he does look very fit. He came in exactly at 175.
Conteh's making a mistake of trying to figure Parlov's style out. He's not going to figure it out. It's not going to be. It's going to be there all night long if he stays there waiting. He's got to be more aggressive. He's got to take the fight to Parlov.
Shook Parlov up with a pretty good short right hand that time. But what your right hand, what he has to do, he has to make a fight out of it. Then he has to catch Parlov with that left hook and those exchanges.
Parlov's last fight, a non-title bout on April 30th of this year, knocked out Tony Green in six rounds at Sarajevo. Conteh fought last in February. Decision, Joe Cox, another American.
Parlov's pretty slick. He's stepping on Conteh's toes with his right foot as it goes in with a jab.
There's that left hook. That's going to be Conteh's big punch tonight.
Less than 30 seconds remaining in the first round. Tim Ryan, Angelo Dundee, Gil Clancy. Red Star Stadium in Belgrade. This stadium, home of one of the two soccer teams in Belgrade, Partizan is the other, and they have their own similarly sized stadium.
About 5 seconds.
Final seconds.
Games at home.
Well, they left the Parlov's eyes alone. They haven't done a thing to them. They haven't put any Vaseline on. So I guess those patches are holding up. They didn't get them all off. And Conteh seems very calm in his corner. Take a nice deep breath and ready to go for round two.
Rudy Ortega, the American referee, at the rules meeting today, made it very clear he was going to watch for all fouls. And I know that we talked in the Cuello fight for Milan about the rather odd left jab that Parlov has. And maybe you fellas can get into that if you see it occur here in the second round.
Well, there are times when he throws a chopping jab, it's almost the backhand, but he hasn't done it yet tonight. He's been using a pretty good straight left hand tonight. Or straight right hand, I should say.
Conteh in his last fight suffered a cut over his left cheekbone, Gil, and it's showing up pretty good from the right, the jab that Parlov's using. You'll notice the way it's showing up on. It'll get worse as it goes along. I expect Conteh to be opened up with that left jab. It's really a right chop, actually.
Well, I'll tell you, even if he does open up on a cheekbone, Angelo, it's not a dangerous area. I mean, there's no way they should stop a fight if a fella does get cut on a cheekbone.
This is round two, scheduled for 15, the WBC Light Heavyweight Championship. Parlov is set. If he wins here tonight, he would like to fight Victor Galindez, the WBA champ, clear up the Light Heavyweight Championship, and he'd like to have that fight at Madison Square Garden in New York. Said there are many Yugoslavs living in New York City, and he'd like them to have a chance to see him. He's got to get by Mr. Conteh here tonight in order to have that opportunity.
You know, as you said, Angelo, Conteh is trying to figure Parlov out. There's no way you're going to figure out Parlov. He's a great technician. What you have to do is fight him. You have to walk in there, move your head, and start throwing punches. I know it's more easy to say than do, but that's the way what he's going to have to do to win the fight.
He who waits on a southpaw gets licked. If he waits like that, Gil, he's definitely going to get licked. I think he's a very good fighter. He's a better technical fighter than Parlov, but Parlov has got a style to mess anybody up.
Under a minute to go in round number two.
You know, Gil, poor Conteh, when he came out of the amateurs, fought a southpaw in his last amateur fight in Madrid, Spain, and he received such bad reviews, he was disgusted almost in turn professional. I can see why he had trouble with southpaw.
Yes, he's boring with that left hand instead of snapping. He's really trying to figure this thing out. So far, he hasn't been able to do it.
Conteh said that he had two fights against Finnegan, southpaw, and he thought that he knew how to handle his style. You fellows seem to think he doesn't.
Finnegan's a southpaw, it's not a southpaw. Finnegan's a fighter. He just walks in and he throws punches. He's not a technician or a tactician in the mode of Parlov.
Even though he's a natural left-hander, you're saying he throws from both sides and is not an orthodox southpaw.
He fights you.
Final seconds of round number two.
Hey, Pete Rose. What's a man really want from his aftershave?
No fancy perfumes or fancy bottles.
It'll be a beautiful summer evening. I think I said it was 9:30 Eastern time. Of course, it's 9:30 here. You folks back home are watching on a nice Saturday afternoon. Kim Ryan, Gil Clancy, and Angelo Dundee. We're waiting round three, and here we go. Parlov in the blue trunks. Now circling to the right of your screen, John Conteh in white from Liverpool, England. Now living in London.
I think Conteh was listening to you a little bit. He's jabbing with
a little bit of a far left jab, yo. Yeah, he threw a nice right hand behind it, too. That's to set up the hook. Let's see if he can throw that 1-2-3 combination.
Well, as you know, your best puncher with a southpaw is a left hook, yo. It looks like Parlov has no respect for Conteh. Watching Parlov makes me respect the Olympics very much more so when I see talent like his with all that amateur background. He's just a fantastic looking fighter.
Well, then he had a great record. He won the Olympics, he won the World Amateur Championship. You know, interestingly enough, when he won the World Amateur Championship, he was on the deck twice.
Conteh with a good flurry. I'd like to alert our stations that at the end of this round we'll be going to a station break.
It's a great round. Both fighters staggered each other. Conteh with a right hand and Parlov with a good straight left hand.
Conteh's starting to get the range a little more now, and I think the more they punch there, the more it's going to favor Conteh. Set it right at the wrong time.
For a knockout, oddly enough, they're are loading up on their punches. Parlov is making a mistake. He should be boxing more.
Under 30 seconds
good
remaining.
Good by Conteh. Staggered Parlov. Left hook underneath, right hand on his chin. Beautiful combination.
We'll be back with more action from Belgrade after this word from the local station.
This is CBS.
It takes more than talent to make it to the Olympics. It takes years of dedication, hard work, good facilities. That's why for Jill Lundeen, the Olympics may never be more than a dream. The Olympic Lottery was created to support winter physical education in New York. When you play the Olympic Lottery, you get a chance to realize your dreams. And kids like Jill Lundeen get a chance to realize theirs.
The Olympic Lottery, where the athletes get a chance to.
If this looks like an ordinary lawnmower, look again. It's a Boland's mulching mower. While it's cutting your grass, it also cuts and recuts the clippings into tiny particles that blow down into your lawn and quickly decompose. No more raking, no more bagging.
The John Monday Night.
He's only had two fights in a little over a year.
Round number four. Scheduled for 15. Conteh in the white trunks to your left now. Parlov, the champion, in blue to your right. Since Conteh broke a hand in a fight against Willie Terre, August of 75, he's had only three fights since August of 75. Will that be a factor? What do you think, Joe?
Well, I tell you, he started the fight a little unsure of himself, and now he's starting to look like the John Conteh of old. He's really winging those punches and putting them together. Now Parlov is moving Conteh the way he wants to move. They can take a real good punch. They both got staggered that time, and they both came back with punches. Very, very good fighters.
When Conteh gets hit hard, he comes firing back. So far, he's been a little wild with those return exchanges, but he's really trying. Parlov maneuvers himself around the ring. Slides over to his right, sets Conteh up, and he just drops in those little sneak punches. They all add up.
You know, Gil, that Conteh's fighting with a passion because you got to remember the title was taken away from him. He didn't lose it in the ring. He was the WBC champion. It was taken away when he didn't fight Quayle.
No question about it. We have two great fighters in there, Angelo.
Got two champions in there, Gil. That's the big thing, and they're both fighting real good, good fighters.
Seconds remaining in round number four.
They're starting to bang heads in there, Gil. I wouldn't surprise either one of them to get cut up in the next couple of rounds, or maybe this round, because they're banging heads now.
Well, I wouldn't like to see either fighter lose on a cut. It's too important to fight.
Well, they're jumping in now, you notice, and that's when you had your clash of heads.
This is round number five, live light heavyweight championship boxing action from Belgrade, Yugoslavia. Matej Parlov on the left in blue, John Conteh now circling to the left in white. Close fight so far, fellas, how do you have it?
I've got it very close. I think there's a point either way, and it's up for grabs right now.
Yeah, right now I have it Parlov 2, Conteh 1, and 1 even.
Thank you.
They just clashed head to head, Angelo.
Yeah, I know. I've seen it coming. And I don't like the way John's trying to push and shove. He's got to stay steady. Got to stay smart. But Parlov will take you apart. That's the way this game of playing. He hits you with the quickest thing.
John Conteh, 27 years of age. Parlov, 29.
He got hurt with that shot, Gil. He really doubled up with it and really got staggered. What surprise to see him get dropped right now, Gil. Shows up.
That's right. He's got to do it on the end of something. There's no question about it. You got to catch him coming out, go behind another punch.
You're in round five.
I like the way Parlov loves him to sleep.
About 30 seconds remaining in the fifth round. One of the few times we saw Parlov get himself off balance. He's good on his feet, isn't he?
Yes, he has got perfect balance. He knows what he's doing at all times.
Watching him train, he trains like a track and field man or a gymnast. He's a superior athlete.
Pretty strong guy, too. Pretty strong.
The Pony Express, nearly 2,000 tough miles from Missouri to California. That took guts. It still does. The kind built into this tire, the Sears Road Handler. We retrace the rugged historic route of the Pony Express to show you how tough it is. Road Handler, Sears' best radio. It's the tire that took on the route of the Pony Express and made it. Wide radial design, double steel belting. The Road Handler, from the home of the radios, Sears. From the people who brought you die-hard batteries, Road Handler tires, and Steady Rider shock absorbers comes the Sears Muzzler, the aluminized muffler that's only $19.99 installed. It's so tough, Sears promises the muzzler will last as long as you own your American-made car, or return it for refund or replacement free. And if Sears installed it, they'll install the new one free. The Muzzler, only $19.99 installed. Only at Sears.
This is round number six, and we have had plenty of action so far. John Conteh on the right of your screen now in white. Monte Parlov, the defending champion in blue. Conteh missed with that overhand, right? Doesn't seem to be favoring his right hand, the one he broke a couple of years ago. Some people thought he favored it against Yaki Lopez.
He had a habit of butting in there. He just butted Parlov over his eye. And he has a history of that.
But you know, with Parlov being butted, the referee didn't say that. We're having to get quick to the end of the round to see if he thinks he was butted. Well, it was an accidental or intentional butt.
Oh, no, it was intentional butt. He tried to do it the round before.
He's being warned now, I think, for using his forearm there, and we'll tell you about the butt rules because they could very well be a factor in this fight. Parlov bleeding on the corner of his right eye, actually the corner of the eyebrow, on the right side.
Tim, it's not in the bad spot in the outside of the eye, but it was definitely an intentional butt. I mean, I can see it the round before he tried to butt.
Conteh scored with a good right hand coming in on him.
Yeah, he's fighting like a wild bull. He's really winging everything.
Banging heads in there, Gil, like I said before.
Conteh's got to settle himself down. He's got to start thinking a little, dropping straight right hands to the body edge, and set Parlov up. He's never going to hit him with that big home run ball. Not unless he catches him coming.
Rudy Ortega, the referee, will have to make the decisions in terms of the butts, accidental or intentional. Of course, intentional butts could lead to disqualification. Certainly the points taken away.
The way Conteh is fighting, winning every punch, he's going to have to get tired.
Just the first round that Parlov loses his control a little bit.
Final seconds of round number six. Spoken to both fighters, he came to Conteh first. We did not see him go to the judges, however, so he may have just been warning Conteh about the butt and may have advised Parlov that he had warned him. We'll see what develops. This is the seventh round of this scheduled 15-round championship bout. Tim Ryan, Gil Clancy, and Angelo Dundee. It has been action-packed so far.
Did a very good job done on Parlov's side. That's Frank Keeney's son in the corner from Italy, and he did a very, very commendable job over the cut.
Parlov is starting to just pull with that right hand, that right hand jab that he has. That's not a good sign. He's got to keep Conteh off with that right jab. Now Conteh's cooling down a little bit, picking the spot. See that right hand to the body? Before he threw a left hand to the body. He's getting control of himself.
I think that Conteh's listening to you, Gilda. Cut it out. I think that Parlov right now is trying to figure out how to offset Conteh's aggressiveness. He had him pretty well set up where he was nailing with shots, nailing with that good left hand. But Conteh's moving away from that left hand now.
You mean that right, the straight left hand in?
Yeah.
Most everyone agrees that Parlov uses his well-known intelligence very well in the ring. He is a graduate of economics with an economics degree from the University of Rijeka, is working on his doctorate, and he thinks in the ring.
Well, he's got to think tonight because he's in there with a real good fighter in Conteh.
There's that big left hook that Conteh has to catch Parlov with coming out. He almost caught him that time.
You ever see a style like that before, Gil?
No,
the Parlov has. He got his own style.
Right. He knows just where to move. He just knows when to roll.
He
when
waves
to slide
that right hand at you.
See him just slide over to the right that time. Get out of the line of fire. He fights back in front of you. He's a tough man to fight. Tough.
Under a minute to go, round seven.
You know, he's surprising me with his physical strength. Because, you know, Conteh's trying to pull him around the ring, but he's right with him. Hey, we have an old saying in our business, when a guy misses, make him pay. And Parlov sure did make him pay when he missed.
Seconds of the seventh round.
They're working on that cut in the corner. They seem to be doing a very good job. I don't know what he's using, but I'm going to borrow from him after the fight.
If I don't get there first, you
great looking right hand, missed left hook, and there goes a bunch of shots. He made him pay right there. Uppercut, left hook, right uppercut.
That brought the partisan crowd to its feet, that flurry, as we await round number eight. There aren't too many Conteh fans in Belgrade tonight, although members of his family and some people from Great Britain are here cheering him on.
I noticed Conteh throwing right hands and throwing back with left hooks. He's trying to set a pattern up. I don't think Parlov's going to run into that, but if he does, he's going to get hurt with that kind of a punch.
Yes, sir.
I'll tell you, Conteh's a never-give-up guy. He caught Ayamano a couple of times. I thought he was in trouble. He just grit his teeth and fire back. The same way he's doing tonight.
Teaches guy in economics, you know, but I tell you, he really moves around and outsmarts Conteh a lot of places. You don't make the same mistake twice.
They just clashed heads again, yeah. Angelo.
Conteh leaped in with a left hook and their heads banged together.
Yeah, he comes in with his head right behind his heart.
Parlov bleeding again from that same cut from the butt.
In the proper places now. He's throwing that left hook underneath. It's going to bring Parlov's right hand down, and maybe he can land that left hook. In the meanwhile, he ran into a beautiful straight left hand by Parlov.
Parlov with 11 knockouts in his 21 wins. Conteh 22 knockouts and 31 victories.
Really opening up that cut more now. They're really bumping heads in there. Parlov to me is strictly keeping Conteh off balance. It won't surprise me when Conteh rushes in like that. If he finds the left hand like that, he can drop
him. Less than 30 seconds remaining in the eighth round. Now there is a visible warning and a point taken away. Telling the judges to take away a point.
For him to take away the point, that means it was a second warning. It had to be Conteh's second warning for him to take the point.
Final seconds in round number 8.
Up the cut and he can't continue. That doesn't mean that Conteh wins the fight. They take the scorecards, add them up, and who's ever ahead at the time is the winner. So therefore, if this cut of Parlov's opens up more than it is and he can't continue, they'll take the scorecards. If he's ahead on the scorecards, he's the winner. So that was a very, very tough decision for Ortega to make, and he warned him and took the point.
He had warned both the fighters at the rules meeting today that he was going to be very strict, and he has delivered on that count, in this case against John Conteh. This is round number 9. Tim Ryan, Gil Clancy, Angelo Dundee at ringside of a most exciting light heavyweight championship fight for the World Boxing Council version of the title.
I tell you, Gil, this is anybody's fight. Any turn of events in this fight, the other fella can win it. It's a very good fight. I have it a very close fight still. And the round he lost for the butt, I think Parlov was winning that round anyhow.
I do too, Ange. I thought Parlov had the round anyway. But I tell you, as you say, if it goes the way it's going now, I think Parlov's going to retain his title. Conteh's going to have to land one big bomb somewhere along the line to turn it around.
The odd part about this fight, Gil, I noticed that Parlov was backhanding Cuello. He has him backhanding once in this fight.
That's
he
right.
He must have corrected it, and he's stinging with that jab.
Minute remaining in the ninth round.
That was much of the fight by John Conteh. Parlov walked right into a straight right hand, didn't bother him a bit.
Good right hand. Obviously, that hand well healed from the break a couple of years ago. Conteh does not look rusty from his inactivity to me, fellas.
Well, I'll tell you, he looks like he's trying a little too hard. He's not the smooth John Conteh that I know.
30 seconds to go in round number 9.
I tell you, Parlov's eye is held up. There's not a drop of blood showing.
That is still the strangest jab I've ever seen. Nonetheless, it works.
But it works.
That's all it counts. Doesn't have to look good.
They say you can't fight too much, but it works. And that's the important thing. You got one worker and six lookers.
But evidently
it's working, so maybe I'll try it one night.
This is round number 10. Conteh on the left in white. Parlov on the right. Now circling to the left in the blue trunks. Throwing out that right-handed jab. He likes to load up on the left. That is apparent.
Conteh's starting to reach now. I think it's the beginning of the end.
He just got nailed with 2 foot straight left hands. He's walking in. Starting to reach.
The snap is starting to go out of his shots. He's trying desperately with the big one, but he's not setting nothing up now.
You know, Parlov doesn't dance around the ring. He just seems to waddle around the ring, but he waddles in the right direction all the time. There he goes, sliding over again.
Stepped on his foot, Joe. I tell you, he's got a knack of doing it.
Here for a glove repair. The left glove, laces have come loose on Conteh Parlov's glove. And the crowd whistling here, that is a form of booing in Europe, and that's for John Conteh, naturally.
They stopped it right at the right time to help Conteh because he was in trouble.
He really paid for a miss. There's part of that glory, where he really got it. Now we're back live. This is the 10th round.
Been the most effective punch, but he's not doing enough of it. That's his best punch, his body shot.
Hey, he's setting a tremendous break, pace right now, Conteh. He won't let the action stop. Great shape, I thought it's only had 2 fights a little over a year. Body shot.
This round.
He's doing the job this round. Okay, now Parlov is using that backhand. He's confused.
Final seconds.
Say, what cars do you...
We're back awaiting the 11th round. How do you have it so far, fellas?
I've got Parlov ahead by a couple points.
I have a 6-3-1 Parlov right now.
Here's a good flurry by John Conteh in that last 10th round.
That was his best round by far. Those left hooks underneath were really hurting Parlov.
Round number 11. This has been nearly a non-stop action bout. Very few clinches. Referee Rudy Ortega from Oakland, California has been letting them work, and they've been working.
I tell you, George Francis must have told him that left hook was effective. That left hook underneath that right elbow. There it is again, because he came right out and started to fire it.
Tape coming loose again. Oh, Parlov's glove, they're going to have to stop the action again.
This is the right glove this time. Laces are taped down, and they've got to stop the action in the time, of course, in the round. A little blood under the right eye of John Conteh, but it may be from Matvey Parlov. We'll watch that to see if he himself has a slight cut.
He's starting to show wear and tear around both eyes, but no breaks or cuts so far. He's holding up real well.
I tell you, Parlov is starting to back up in a straight line instead of going in a circle the way he was going earlier. That's why John is able to land some of those good punches that he landed last round. He just hit him with a good left hook, and he opened that cut.
I'd like to alert our stations along the line at the end of this round. We'll be going to a station break. Angelo Dundee, Gil Clancy, and Tim Ryan here at Red Star Stadium. And now Ortega, the referee, really giving Conteh a warning.
Well, the referee gave Conteh a warning, and the crowd gave us a warning. They're starting to throw things.
Oh, really? Already, huh?
Well, I told him before to get the Irish guy.
Well, they're MMA as usual.
Those body punches of Conteh are really starting to take effect, Joe. And hurt you, Parlov. That's the best punches he's been throwing all night.
Less than a minute to go in round 11.
For the first time, Parlov is starting to show wear and tear, Bill. Do you notice?
Yes, he's tired now. I tell you, he's going to have to get a second win.
Yeah.
You know what happens a lot of times in a fight like this? Conteh already got a second win. Parlov hasn't yet. Got to look for him to get a second win and rally back.
Under 30 seconds to go in the 11th round. Crowd obviously behind Matvey Parlov, as you might expect. He is the national sports hero of Yugoslavia.
There's that left hook underneath.
That's a punishing punch.
Yes, it is. Set up the left hook on the chin.
We'll be back with more action from Belgrade after this word from your local station.
Tony Randall, Monday, 4:30.
Round number 12, just underway. John Conteh out quickly. He is in the white trunks, now moving to the left. Parlov in blue on the right of your screen. Close fight with only these four rounds remaining. If it goes the distance.
Got two well-conditioned fighters in there, and they're really pulling out all stops. Conteh came to life the last round and looked excellent. He's trying to throw that great left hook downstairs, left hook on top. He's really taking charge.
For Parlov to pull himself together. He's got to get that second win in. Although those left hooks underneath, as you say, take an awful lot out of you. Well, they say, kill the body and the head will die.
Parlov has gone 15 rounds three times since he turned pro 23 fights ago.
Heads are banging again.
We know what's happened, Gil. Parlov has slipped with Conteh's left hook, and he's coming inside of it, and he's going wrapping his left arm around him. This is not intentional by Conteh. He's doing a good number in there.
Uh-huh. When Parlov is confused, he goes to that backhand jab. He just did it again. I have to commend the referee. He's done a marvelous job. under the circumstances here.
The cut reopened, only it's worse, Bill. Bleeding work.
Well, we may have to resort to that rule. I sure hope not.
Minute to go in round 12.
Punches, you know, they're accumulating. He started to wobble a little bit.
30 seconds remaining in the 12th round.
J.C. Penney presents the sports shirt that feels as good as it looks.
Angela Conteh, sister of John, here with other members of the family. He comes from a large-sized family. And here's a look at some of the action from round number 12 on replay. Here we go. Back to live action for round 13.
The last three rounds is what you call, this is what it's all about. The man who's got the most is will be the winner, because you got to really take out all stops and really let it all hang out. But these are the rounds that are going to decide this fight.
Hey, this is a war of attrition right now. You said, Angelo, two champions are in there.
John Conteh stripped of his title for refusing to meet Miguel Cuello. Cuello went on to beat Jesse Burnett to win the championship, then lost it to Parlov.
Conteh has a swelling over his right eye. It's the largest swelling I've seen so far. It looked like a lump. I don't know where it came from.
Angelo, you said this fight would go 15, and we're in round 13.
Well, I felt, you know, they're being such great fighters and having such great body strength and being in great shape, both great competitors. I thought they would go to limit, but it wouldn't amaze me if one of them gets stopped in the next three rounds.
Well, you got these wild again. Look, he had a good panic going through with that left hook underneath. He stopped throwing it. They tried to throw it then. Got to stay with what works. Parlov seems to have lost a lot of strength.
Remember, there are three neutral judges doing the scoring, the referee, Rudy Ortega, and two more Americans, Dick Young and Tony Perez.
You know, it's the first time in history three Americans have ever refereed and judged fights in Europe. First time in the history of boxing.
Both managers said they were extremely pleased, as were the fighters. They had quibbled over European judges.
I tell you, Conteh's manhandling him now.
Less than a minute remaining in round 13.
This is a great light heavyweight fight. There's that new punch you were talking about, Angelo.
Conteh scoring.
There goes that left uppercut.
And there went Paulo's mouthpiece flying across the ring.
No, that was somebody threw something at you again, Joe.
It was hard, too. Seconds to go in the 13th round. Conteh trying the uppercut again. This is the way. How do you have it, fellas?
Well, I think it's up for grabs. I think Parlov has to have a big round to retain his title.
15th round, here we go.
Punch to change this fight around was that left hook to the body by Conteh. Once he started to weave in and throw that punch, it changed the fight.
Conteh fighting furiously as he has from the opening bell, but really going out of these late rounds.
I'll tell you, the way he's going, he's liable to hit the referee and Parlov. He's throwing punches.
The crowd cheering Parlov's every punch, whether it lands or not. That one did.
I tell you, those 2 points that the referee deducted from Conteh, that's the same as 2 rounds. That's a big deduction.
Point must system, 10 points to the winner of a round, 9 or less to the loser. So if you have one taken away, you're in a lot of trouble.
I tell you.
Minute remaining.
Well, this man could decide to fight.
Good shot from Parlov, and Conteh rallies back.
This has been a great fight, Gil.
It's been a great fight, Gil.
Great.
Two world
champion.
I think Conteh started a little bit too late.
Less than 30 seconds. Most of the crowd now coming to its feet.
What effort, Conteh, with that last shot. He's catching him coming now. I got to applaud these two guys myself. Great fight!